Hey there, my name is Rii Brashler, and in this video, I want to talk to you about my three favorite things to purchase after you get your LV1 from Waves. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear, no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, with my LV1 Classic, this thing is awesome. Obviously, there is a beautiful touchscreen in front of me, but there's a few things that I like to add to the LV1 that just makes it a little bit easier when you're on the road or typing or needing to do some patching. Now, again, the touchscreen is perfect. There's nothing I would change about it. It is multi-touch, so I can go here and move multiple faders at the same time, and it's great. However, when you go into the patch and you're faced with this big thing of patching, if you have fat fingers, kind of like I do, sometimes it's easy to accidentally patch something wrong. And so you kind of have to watch and look around, and you can select things, which makes it easier to find where you want to route. But you can purchase a trackball mouse or a mouse, and you can plug it in to the USB just like you would a computer, and then you can use that mouse for doing some of your patching. So for instance, if I'm doing some patching here, I'm grabbing my trackball mouse. Now, the nice thing about a trackball mouse is that there is a wheel for actually moving the mouse, and then you just have your clicks. And the nice thing is, when you are on a compacted area at front of house where we have to kind of confine things as close as they can be, a trackball is nice because it can stay in one spot, and then I can simply just move my mouse around with my thumb and then click on things. Now, what's great about this particular mouse, and this is called the ProtoArc trackball mouse, and it is the ProtoArc EM01, and there will be a link down in the description, and I'm not paid for this at all. These are products that I purchased a while ago and have been using for a really long time. Now, what I love about this mouse is that it can connect to three things all within one mouse. So there are two Bluetooth connections, which I would connect to my MacBook and then another computer if it supports Bluetooth. Typically, I have two Macs and I'm connecting to both of them. And then there is a dongle that's included with the mouse that I then plug into the back of the LV1. And then I can actually select between the three computers or the connections with this button right here in the middle right here. And so if I just go ahead and press this, I can cycle between the three different things. Now, one is going to be the USB dongle connection that's included. And so here is my mouse on my LV1. And so what's great about this is I can go through and easily do my patching, and I don't have to worry about doing a mispatch, because when I pull this up, I can see where I'm wanting to route, and I can just start clicking things and adding my patch as I see fit. And then if I'm wanting to jump over to my computer where I'm doing my multi-track from, or maybe a QLab session from, all I have to do is just press this button, and there is my MacBook. So now I am controlling the mouse on my MacBook. And then if I go down to three, then here is my other computer that I have as well. And then if I need to jump back to my LV1, boom, there's my LV1. The next thing that I would be adding in is this little keyboard. So this is a wireless keyboard that works on 2.4 gigahertz, and on the back of this unit, it has a little receiver that's USB that I go and plug in. Now, I picked this up probably 4 years ago when I was programming servers and video rooms and everything like that, and what was great about this is on this single unit, there is a touchpad and a keyboard all built into the same unit, and this made it really easy to go into a server room, plug in my USB dongle, and be able to enter in whatever I need to into that server or into that video console or whatever. But for the Waves LV1, if we go and want to rename something and don't have a keyboard connected, then all we have to do is just double tap into here, and then a keyboard on screen pops up. Now, this is great, but when you're doing your patching and when we are in here actually putting in all of our inputs, if I double tap into this and then I go and name something, you know, it's just, it kind of takes a little bit of time for the keyboard to pop up on the screen. So if I have this, I can actually just go through a whole lot faster. And so let me go ahead and grab my little dongle And we'll just go ahead and plug this guy in. And turn this guy on. Now, like I was saying, there is a touchpad on this, so I can go and use this as a mouse. But what's great is I can go and label things. So I can tap into here, and maybe this vocal is Brian. And then I can press tab to go to the next line down. And maybe this is Will, and this is Sarah. And just like that. So what's nice about this is I can quickly go and enter in things into the LV1. And now when it comes to actually doing the fader adjustments, so for instance, if I was wanting to go in here and pull up my any of these plugins. So for instance, I want to adjust my low cut, and maybe I want this to be exactly 125. Instead of going and hunting around with the fader, I can just go in here and go 125, enter, boom. And now my low cut is set to 125. So the keyboard is really nice. The mouse is also really nice. Now, these are two additions that I always add to any console that has the ability of having a mouse or a keyboard attachment, and the Waves LV1 Classic is one of those. Now, the next thing that I want to suggest to you is a USB drive, and this is a tiny little USB drive. This is from Samsung, and this has really fast read and write speeds, which is fantastic. Now, this is also 128 gigabytes, which is fast enough and big enough for what I needed for, but they also have a 256 and a 512 gigabyte version. Now, what's great about this is I have tested this within the LV1, and this allows me to record directly to this from the LV1 Classic. And so what I do with this is I just go and toss it into one of the USB slots. Now what I do is I can save my sessions or plugin settings, or I can actually record to it. So if I go over to setup and I go into my mixer settings, over here on right here, we have our record settings. And so what I can do is I can go and drop into my Samsung here, and I'm just going to create a new folder and call this recordings. Perfect. And we can enter. And then if I double tap into this right here, we can go ahead and select this folder. And boom. Okay, so here we go. We now have this location selected. Now it will tell me how much available space that I have on this thumb drive, which is fantastic. It will also tell me how much time I have remaining in recording to this thumb drive. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do now that I have my location selected is just go ahead and press test. Now this is going to take a few minutes to do its testing, but it is going to temporarily record some stuff to your USB drive and make sure that the speed of that USB drive is good enough for being able to record to. And so my session is at 48K, but I've also tested this at 96K, and both of the tests prove positive for this particular USB drive, which is great. So as we can see, we have this test passed at 48 kilohertz. Now, the great thing about this little USB drive is it is waterproof, shockproof, temperatureproof, magnetproof, and X-ray proof, which is crazy. So it's waterproof up to 72 hours in seawater. It can withstand up to 1500 Gs of impact force, and it withstands operating temperature of negative 25 degrees Celsius all the way up to 85 degrees Celsius. Non-operating, it can go all the way down to negative 40 degrees Celsius, which is pretty crazy. Now, at the time of this recording, the prices of these three products are not super expensive by any means. So for the USB stick, we have 128 gigabyte as $15. There's a 256 gigabyte, which is $23, and a 512 gigabyte, which is just massive, for $60. Then you have the trackball mouse, which is around $48. And then you have the little keyboard, which is about $23. So all in all, we can add some great functionality to our LV1 Classic by just adding these three things. We have a keyboard, we have a mouse, and we have the ability of recording. Now, with the recording, I do want to mention that down here, we can see that we have about 5¾ hours of recording. Now, I do want to show you where you can patch for the recording. So if we go over to our patch and go output, and we select our LV1 Classic here, we have 16 channels of recording ability to that little flash drive. This is fantastic because we can record a stereo mix and maybe our lead vocal or a couple different things. So for instance, my mix here, I have some mix buses, and let's go all the way down to the bottom, and here is my record streams. So boom and boom, there's my record. And maybe I want to also record my stream just to make sure that those sound good. And then let's go ahead and add in some direct outs of my vocals. So if we go here, what we can do is we can change these to be input, pre, or post. And so if we go input and I go and add this on 5, what this is doing is this is taking a recording of this channel directly off the input. If we have this set on pre, this is a pre-fader recording. And then we could also do post-fader, or we can even do post with panning. Now, all of those are available to you by just selecting between these things. And so if we wanted to record all of my vocals, I can just go through simply down and select all of the vocals that I want to. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on really any production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are gonna be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.